to everybody here in St Mary's Church, Welwyn, and good morning to those of you that are watching our live stream, and good afternoon, good evening to anybody who's watching on some sort of catch-up note. Today's programme is devised really to have a summer theme because it's August. The weather might be telling us different, but it's August. And so I have devised with Michelle, who's going to join me today, to sing some songs. I've devised a summer feeling programme. As I was thinking through it last night, I realised that there's actually only one piece in a minor key. It's just the way it's happened, but all the others are in major keys, which I think is very summery in itself. You're welcome to applaud, but where there are two songs, or in the little bit in the middle where I'm going to play three pieces, if you could reserve your applause if you wish to give any to the end. So I'm going to begin today's programme with Henry Smart's Festive March.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
just going to break with the tradition of not saying anything in the middle of the recital to say something about the last song that Michelle sang. Because you'll see in the notes, it says that, you know, it looks like, it seems as if Eric Coates was inspired by some place he visited, you know, Maldives or Seychelles or the Bahamas or something like that. And in fact, that's not the case. So I didn't want you to know this before Michelle sang, because it just might, but it's quite interesting. The view that inspired him was the view from Selsey in Sussex, East Beach, which is not the beach that's sandy with all the caravans, or Selsey Bill, which is famous, but the East Beach, which is unfamous, has no shops and just has a lifeboat station, and is all pebbly. So not much in the way of attractions on East Beach, but the view from East Beach across the bay to Bognor Regis. That was the view that inspired him. And in fact, if you ever go to Selsey, go to East Beach, there's a little brass plaque which actually says that.
Thank you. to Linden and Michelle for that concert. Really, that's all that remains for me to say. I was just rehearsing, not rehearsing, researching, that's the word. researching very hastily at the end there. The role of the organist in wartime. And I did come up with a couple of things. The Royal Albert Hall, at various cathedrals, and at the Brighton Pavilion in particular, organists put on wartime concerts to kind of raise spirits. We haven't been through a war, but we've been through a fairly tough 18 months. And I think Linden has done very much the same as those wartime organists did with these recitals. I mean, today is quite a jolly affair, but Linden beforehand reminded us of the sort of deep, dark days of January when we're in the middle of quite a severe lockdown, when the heating of the church was off, and she would come in here into an empty church with Nikki, who's very kindly helped with recording and live streaming, and in a cold, dark church with nobody at all, sort of record these things so that they could be put out on the web just to kind of raise the morale of the troops, as it were. So I think these recitals, Linden today with Michelle, have been a great sort of way of raising spirits. So thank you very much. This is the last because, firstly, hopefully we're coming out of those dark days, but also because happily for her, but sadly for us, Linden is retiring to Northumberland, and we wish her well. So just to say two things, if you'd like to say thank you for today's recital from Michelle and Linden, do think of donating to the church, either by the bowl or on our website, to church funds, which is what they wish to give to today. But then also to say, Linden's final Sunday will be Sunday the 12th of September, so we will be making a presentation to Linden and saying farewell. So particularly if you've joined these recitals, you might put that date in your diary as the final time that Linden will be playing for us in this church. So again, just thank you to Michelle and Linden, and all the best for the future. Thank you very much.